Hey everybody, it's me, Zach, this is Judy, and welcome back to our channel. Okay everybody, so today I'm doing a video I wasn't really planning on doing initially. I mean, to be quite honest, I had originally started doing a Nikocado avocado reaction, and as I listened to Nikocado talk about how Orlin did this and Orlin did that and, you know, did his standard clickbait of domestic violence and things like that, I was like, you know, I've really wanted to speak out about a certain girl of ours, Amberlynn Reed, and her deciding to clickbait domestic violence in her title, and just thought, wow, maybe I should make that video instead. And besides, like, I was really over Nikocado. So we're gonna do that today. I appreciate your patience with that and understanding. Also, you know, if domestic violence is something that is challenging for you to listen to, consume, or to listen to, like, conversations about it, totally understand if you need to click off this video, because this is your warning that I'm going to be talking about that kind of content here in this video. But before we get to that, let's check in with Judy Lou Who and see what she has to say. Judy?
Quiet on set, I need to rest. I need my beauty sleep. Please do not disturb me.
Okay. All right. Okay, Jude. Okay. I love you. You could go back to taking a nap. Okay. A few days ago, December 19th, yeah, just a couple days ago, 2 days ago, our girl Amberlynn Reed posted a video titled My Girlfriend Wants to Hurt Me, and it was a part of her series of Vlogmas here on her channel. As you may know, every single year, she does a whole Vlogmas thing where she posts every single day for the most majority of December, and then she always ends up quitting before it's over. In case you're wondering what actually happens in that video and you don't want to click on it because you don't want to see domestic violence or you don't want to see things like that, what really happens is that Becky just keeps making her laugh, and because Amberlynn hasn't been feeling well, her stomach has been sore, and Becky is intentionally making her laugh, and it's making her stomach hurt even more. And so Amberlynn says, oh, I'm gonna title this video My Girlfriend Wants to Hurt Me since you keep making me laugh.
Don't make me laugh, it hurts.
I know, Ben.
Oh, is that why you're making me laugh? Because you want me to hurt? I'm just kidding.
No. Because of COVID and stuff, we really don't get to go nowhere.
Nope.
So it's like, if I have to run to the store, I'm just going to wear my Mind Your Business pants.
Mind Your Business pants.
Yeah, here's another pair. Mind Your Business.
Becky. Oh, it hurts to laugh. Stop.
Sorry, babe.
Stop being funny. She watches my videos?
Yeah.
Oh, what's up, girl?
She loves you.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
Ow. I'm laughing again. I did not know that.
I love beanies, okay? But I don't know if it's just my fat head or what is it, but it just slowly starts to do this number right here. And then pretty soon I'm looking like, I don't know, Dave Chappelle.
Stop.
Joe Pesci.
Becky, you're purposely being funny because you want me to be in pain.
No.
This Vlogmas is going to be titled, My Girlfriend Wants to Hurt Me. Stop.
Sorry.
Stop.
No more.
At the end of the day, pretty harmless overall. Like, nobody's actually, like, intentionally hurting somebody. Becky's just a comedian, a real good old joker, okay? So that's all that really happens. But honestly, it really upsets me that she decides to go forward with this title. I mean, most of all, because, like, there are so many other clickbait titles that would be, like, clickbait in the sense of, like, she's only putting it in there to get people to click on it, but would actually be true about what she's experiencing, right? Like, she could say, my stomach really hurts, or things like that, and she would probably still get the same number of clicks and views, etc., on her videos. I guess that's, like, why it frustrates me the most, is that, like, she has things that she can clickbait and get people to come and watch her videos without, like, making a mockery of people who have really experienced the challenges of an abusive relationship where their partners might actually really want to hurt them. It's also frustrating because I remember I have been watching Amberlynn's Vlogmas. I haven't stopped watching her in general, even though I do not really post a ton of content on her, but I clearly have posted some content about her recently. And a few vlogs ago, I feel like, I mean, I couldn't even pinpoint the exact one because I don't keep receipts like that these days. But she was saying that she didn't understand why people thought of her as, like, a female Nikocado Avocado. Like, I think somebody had posted that in her comments and she was reading her comments and has said that. I don't think that that is a fair representation of her, to be honest. Like, I think her content is way different than what Nikocado puts out there. But I certainly think it's a fair representation in this case where she's clearly picking a title that she knows is going to get people riled up and come and click and watch her videos and leave comments and things like that. Like, she certainly knows what she's doing in that sense, like Nikocado, and she seemed to like, well, she didn't necessarily take offense to it because she seems to like Nikocado Avocado for some reason, but she seemed to be like frustrated that people thought of her that way, and it's just like, then why are you going and doing this? You know what I'm saying? But like I said at the beginning of this, I didn't initially feel compelled to make a whole entire video about this, mostly because, well, one, I already had ingredients to make her chili before she even posted this video. So I was like, oh my gosh, like I was already planning on doing this. I really am trying to limit how much content about Amberlynn I make and what kind of content about Amberlynn I make. And I'm not trying to post several videos. Like, my whole channel, I hope you all have seen now, is more than just like an Amberlynn Reed channel, a Chantal channel. Like, I'm doing lots of things, and for the most part, people seem to like that variety. So I'm not trying to exhaust the Amberlynn Reed content, okay? I also think, like, when it comes to the more serious things that Amberlynn does on her channel that are problematic, or even just like, maybe not problematic, but even just things with like her health and things like that, like, it goes to such a dark place for some people so quickly. Like, so quickly. Even if I'm not trying to be dark or negative or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Like, people come into my comments and they get so dark so quickly. And I'm just like, this is not what I signed up for. Like, we certainly do need to talk about serious things like domestic violence. I think when we don't talk about those things, it's like, what are we doing? But what we don't need to do is like come into the comments and be like nasty, hateful, and horrible people. And so to some extent, I try to also protect myself from that, let alone like people who might be reading through my comments and things like that. So yeah, I guess in general, I've been trying to draw some kind of line in the sand for what I will and will not make content about. But I certainly think that this is something worthy of conversation and should be talked about. But I guess like, most importantly, I was kind of waiting to see how she would respond to it. I mean, when she first posted this video on, I think it was Saturday, I was like, huh, this is real sus, but listen, I'm gonna give her the benefit of the doubt. Maybe she really didn't think about it. Maybe she'll come out, give us an apology. Maybe she'll change the title. You know, I was really curious because honestly, if she would have came and the next day said like, hey, that was really unthoughtful of me to do or say or to put out into the world, then I could have been like, okay, girl, that's great. Like, I'm glad you realized that there was a problem and you've moved on. We love to see that. It's called growth. People make mistakes. People can change. I'm okay with that if y'all are okay with that. But then find me looking brand new, acting real dumb when I'm surprised that that's the last video that we get of Vlogmas 2020, okay? It's the last Vlogmas video. The next day she just stops posting. And listen, I mean, listen, it's kind of been a Christmas tradition for me at this point to not get to experience a full conclusion to the Amberlynn Reed Vlogmas moment, okay? So I really shouldn't be surprised. This is really like a tradition for me at this point to just, you know, take bets and see how long she'll last. But I was kind of like, I don't know, this seems kind of sus that this is coming right after you post a really controversial clickbaity title. Like, I'm just calling it what it is. It's sus. And I guess before we go too much more into talking about her quitting Vlogmas, I did just want to speak a little bit about how for all intents and purposes. I haven't minded Vlogmas. Last year, her Vlogmas was out of control. I did so many reactions last December because it felt like every other day there was something wild going on. And this year, I'm going to say, like, it's been pretty chill, and I haven't been that bothered, to be honest. Like, to some extent, I've looked forward to watching it daily, and I know that might surprise some of you, but I've always been, like, an avid viewer of Amberlynn. Like, I've always talked about how I watch Amberlynn's channel like it's a television series, and I've been invested for a long time. So no, I haven't stopped watching her, and to be honest, Vlogmas this year has not been that bad. I think, like, the thing that most people could probably criticize her about, and even I would probably to some extent be like, girl, this is unnecessary, is the, like, excessive gift giving. It's definitely giving me, like, Destiny era gift giving right before Destiny ended up leaving her. Like, that Christmas, do y'all remember that, where she bought Destiny, like, 12,000 gifts, that's an exaggeration, but 12,000 gifts, and then in January, Destiny left her. If y'all haven't visited that time in the Amberlynn universe, you should go back and watch some of those videos, but she literally bought her, like, a shit ton of gifts. Anyways, I do think that it's, like, mildly excessive, the amount of gifts that they're getting for each other, but I also just kind of feel like, you know, we have all been through our own personal hell in 2020, so, like, however people want to celebrate this Christmas, like, celebrate. Do what you gotta do, truly. Like, I'm not here to rain on anybody's holiday parade. I'm not even a big holiday person, which is why, for me, this is also very excessive, but if that's how you want to show somebody you love and care about them this year, then go for it. Like, truly go for it. Do what you gotta do. I would encourage you to try to be mindful of, like, not wasting things, not getting stuff you don't need, but listen, enjoy your Christmas 2020, and then in 2021, nip that in the bud, okay? Stop the excessive spending for 2021. Make that your New Year's resolution. But going back to that, she did quit Vlogmas right after she posted this controversial title, and her reason for Vlogmas was health related, which for me is kind of like on that line of, like, what I do and do not want to talk about related to Amberlynn. Like, I don't have an interest in, like, examining her health. I hope she's taking care of herself. I hope that she's doing what she needs to be happy and healthy. And I hope she continues to have a long life ahead of her. But she did take to the community tab of her YouTube channel, a la Chantal Marie, Chantal Show, Foodie Booty, Daily Chantal, Chantal Show, Big Beautiful Me, whoever, whatever she's calling herself these days. And Amberlynn said, I gotta get on this community tab and I gotta let folks know. I gotta let folks know what's going on here. And it was a lot, to be honest. It was a lot. So it started 2 days ago, and she said, norovirus is what I have. I get it every single year in either December or January. Which, I mean, to some extent, like, I feel like it's true, honest. I think that that's representative of the things that have happened in the past, as have been documented on her videos. With that being said, I do kind of feel like last year, she didn't mention norovirus. Last year was, like, the UTI issue, where she had, like, multiple UTIs over and over again. But a historian of Amberlynn Reed, I am not. So, you know, she says this happens every year. Who am I to question? Then she posted, I'll be posting a video about why I didn't post today. I have a valid reason. That was 19 hours ago from the time that I'm filming this. She posted no video. No video has been posted explaining what happened. Then she posted and said, I'm honestly saddened and repulsed by the things I saw under my community post. You have no idea what's going on in my life right now. Reading shit like that makes me not want to explain myself, just like my true supporters continuously tell me not to do. For those leaving hate and slander, it's your fault I'm not gonna stop being so open with my audience. To those who support me and are patient with me, you're the reason why I'll continue posting videos at all. As for Vlogmas, it's over. And that was 16 hours ago from the time that I'm recording this. So that post in particular leads me to have a lot of questions. Like, I don't know. I think I would really like her to just like listen to what she's saying and listen to her own advice, which is there are a group of people who want a certain kind of content from her, who appreciate her, who support her. And if she really focused on those folks, I think she would realize that she would just be happier on YouTube in general. I certainly know that like that has been my experience is like, who are the people that are gonna come and watch me regardless of what kind of content I'm gonna make? And let me focus on making them happy with what I'm putting on YouTube. And it's just been great. I think like these community posts are doing the exact opposite of that, right? Like she says, I'm gonna keep going for the people who do support me and who are patient with me. But yet these posts specifically are addressing the people who aren't happy with her, right? Because the people who do support her, I've seen, they do exist. They are in her comments and they do say things like, hey, like, just take care of yourself. Do what you need to do. And none of them, I don't think any of them are like expecting some kind of response from her. So then she also 16 hours ago posted, yes, I got tested for COVID. It was negative. Okay. Like, again, you're posting for people who don't believe you anyway. So if you're going to continue posting for people who don't believe you, you posting this stuff is not going to help them. It's not going to change their mind, I guess is what I want to say. Like, that's what I would say to Amberlynn if, like, she was my friend in real life and was sitting right next to me. Like, why are you trying to change the minds of people who are 100% committed to not understanding you, not believing you, not supporting you? You know, like, nothing's going to change their mind. And then she posted one last thing 8 hours ago. I saw it this morning when I woke up. And she said, people aren't believing me that I got tested for COVID, which is ridiculous. I have absolutely no reason to lie. Here I am answering some questions before they are brought up first. What I have blocked out is the address and the doctor's signature. Why it's folded is because I folded it up and put it in my purse before heading to the ER after urgent care. And then she has this photo of a note that I guess somebody at the urgent care wrote for her and saying like, if you have questions, please let us know. So I guess my question here is like, what is your goal? What is your, like, what did you want to get out of this to grow and further your channel, your community? Whose mind were you trying to change? Cause it's unclear to me. Like this to me reads as like, either somebody who is just like really, really frustrated and really does need to take time away, or like somebody who is trying to drum up some kind of engagement on their channel to get people interested again. And listen, Lord knows I'm not getting the views I once was. It doesn't look like Amberlynn is either. So maybe she has a master plan here of re-engaging the community, getting the views back up. I don't know. I don't know. But you know, I guess like what I will say is I don't think clickbaiting domestic violence is the way to get those views. You know, you feel me? Do you feel me there? I certainly would never stoop to that. That would not be a direction I would choose to go with my personal channel, because I just think it's like offensive, inappropriate, and uncalled for. Honestly, Amberlynn has been better off in general when she's just left her health stuff off of her channel. She's talked about how she feels better when she's not talking about it. She enjoys her job more when she's not talking about it. And yet here we are talking about it. Now, the other thing is that just reminded me, she also has been posting on Instagram today about it. And she did also clarify on there why she quit Vlogmas, because she's doing one of her infamous Q&As and somebody asked, why did you stop with Vlogmas? You literally only had like 8 more days to go. And then she said, I ended up missing one day due to being at urgent care and then being at the hospital, not norovirus related. Once I posted that, I missed a day due to being sick and stuck at the hospital. People flipped and started harassing me. I then realized that if I had a normal job, I wouldn't be allowed at the workplace anyhow due to what's wrong with me. Not COVID, I tested negative, per doctor's orders. To top it off, being harassed by haters over something like that or like this made me realize that I didn't want to mess with my mental health while also trying to heal. The only people ever mad at me for not posting are the ones who belittle me every day. They don't deserve Vlogmas. Okay, so first of all, it's cool that you're comparing your job to like a regular job where people get sick notes to the doctor and things like that. You can certainly make choices about what you do or do not want to do on your channel every day. I do myself every day, but I think it's like a little besides the point to say like, if I was working a normal job, you're not working a normal job. So like that comparison is wild, okay? Weird to me. I think you make good points of like the people that don't care if you post don't care. So like, why are you continuing to address it? I think it's one thing to like make a post saying like, hey, like I've not been feeling well, so I'm just gonna peace out from the rest of Vlogmas. And it's another thing to fight with people and trying to justify and prove that you are sick or you're not feeling well. So I don't know. It's also just like frustrating, and it's hard for me not to say like this might have something to do with this video she posted related to domestic violence, because if you go to that post or that video, all the comments are about the clickbait. Almost all the comments, the top comments are about the clickbait title. So there's one that says, why are you using domestic violence for clickbait? There's another that says, after your whole domestic violence scandal, this title is definitely not cute. If you're not aware of that, she did in the past make a video where she accused an ex of similar things, domestic violence and things like that. I don't talk about it intentionally on my channel a lot because like I'm not here to say what did or did not happen. I think that that's like not my place and I don't care to talk about it. There's another person that says, reported for using domestic violence as clickbait. There's a person that says, what a shock, Amber Lynn disappears after using an offensive clickbait title. Her idea of damage control is weak AF. Another person that says, clickbaiting domestic violence is trash even for Amber Lynn. She doesn't deserve to have a platform. So it's just like all of them. It's like comment after comment after comment about how people are offended by the title. And it's just wild because she has all this to say about her health, which she claims she doesn't want to talk about on her channel. And then she comes here and just ignores all of these like legitimate concerns of feedback over the title she used. So I don't know. Tell me what you think down below in the comments. I would love to hear your thoughts and feelings and opinions. Also, though, keep it kind, keep it nice. You don't need to comment about her looks when the reality is that her behaviors are problematic, right? Like, focus on the behaviors and not her as a person and what she looks like, okay? All right, and yeah, that's all I have for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to subscribe down below and hit the bell button so you get notifications every single time I go live or I post a new video. And as always, make sure to live, laugh, love, like, comment, share, and follow me on all of my social media. I will see y'all next time, okay? Bye!